Howling Cow Dairy Products has always operated under the rules established through FDA program called the Pasteurized Milk Ordinance. Pasteurized Milk Ordinance actually is a HACCP program in itself, even though it was established decades ago. It dictates where the hazards are and what the critical control points are to be monitored and the documentation required. It's a pretty definitive document without a lot of leeway. Current HACCP standards go far beyond that. A HACCP program really is customized to that facility where you really have to go in and evaluate all the risks associated with it and establish those control points that's best for that operation.
In the Howling Cow processing plant, we're looking at pasteurization temperature and pasteurization time as critical control points. We're also making sure that those temperatures are correct on our outflow into the pasteurized tanks, so that they're filled at the proper temperature and they're put directly into a cooler that's the proper temperature that keeps our milk storage life the longest, the shelf life the longest, and the bacteria as low as possible. Every time we bring in a batch of sugar or a batch of cocoa powder, or anytime we go to the farm and pick up a bulk tank of milk, we're going to log those in, make sure that the lots are recorded, and make sure either we have an analysis of that product or that we're taking an analysis for ourselves and culturing it and make sure that we know what the bacteria levels are in that product.
The Pasteurized Milk Ordinance has routine inspections built in and significant quarterly inspections. They have a very detailed inspection program that is controlled by the North Carolina Department of Agriculture and Consumer Services. Our state regulatory officer comes in routinely. Every month he's pulling samples, he's coming in just taking a look at the plant, not doing a strict formal inspection, but then on a quarterly basis, they come in, they do a full written inspection where we're graded and documented all the facilities and the quality and the cleanliness. And at that time, they also do significant physical checks on the processor, determining that the temperature recording devices are accurate, that the flow rate of the system is where it should be, and that all the regulatory lockout tagouts that we have are in place. As far as our federal inspections, FDA will inspect our facilities every 24 to 36 months. They do a significant inspection. They're checking warehouses, looking under pallets. They're looking at our utility generation that supplies all the water and utility systems for that. Anything that can impact product quality or create adulteration or post-process contamination is inspected by them. They also inspect our charts and our retained records to ensure that we've been in compliance.
Right now, what Howling Cow is doing with all of our records is basically just storing them for future use.
They're typically reviewed at the end of the day and at the end of the week and checked off by various people. But the feedback loop that is so signature to a HACCP program to create that continuous improvement is not necessarily there. It could be there, but it's the onus of that operating plant, where in the HACCP program, it's an integral part of that system. The great thing about a HACCP program is the act of going through it educates you more than you ever realized you knew about your process. So suddenly, you know your process better than you did, better than anyone else knows. And that gives you a good, firm foundation to discuss regulatory issues and have a give and take with anyone who comes in to critique your operation. The world's changing, and many of the customers that you want to sell to demand the ability to come in and see your operation. So you want to know it better than anyone else, and you want to be able to explain it. And that confidence that developing a HACCP plan will give you might land your next big customer.